just being here in the Athletes Village is unbelievable. It's a huge place, and it's really neat. It's So every track meet, they go to. I take this from my mom. It's something she gave to me, and I usually put it in my shorts when I compete, so it's right with me.
In Guangzhou, Andy White realized his dream of wearing the Canadian jersey. It was a childhood dream. He'd held it since the moment he made a promise to his mother.
It's such an honor to wear my Canadian jersey, mainly because of my mom. So when she was 17, she made her first national team, and she ran for Canada at the Pan American Cup. So my mom, she passed away in January 2010. She had breast cancer. So for me to have this achievement of making a Canadian team, something that she had done, and you know, it was such a special accomplishment for her. It really made it a special one for me to follow in her footsteps. And you know, for me, my mom always said, follow your dreams.
Andy is a student of fine arts in Vancouver and a sporting hero of the university. But the qualification process for the World University Games was fraught, to say the least. After a lot of frustration, Andy had just 48 hours to qualify for Guangzhou, and the qualifying meeting in Lethbridge was a long way away.
I put a bed in the back of my dad's truck, and I hopped in it, and I drove 1,200 kilometers across the country to Lethbridge, Alberta. And I went there to compete, and when I got there, it was not a good day to compete. It was pouring rain, so windy. Umbrellas were turning inside out from spectators on the sidelines, and I just couldn't get off a good throw. I said, well, the deadline for FISU is tomorrow.
Andy would attempt one last shot at qualifying for Guangzhou, the last possible meeting in Kamloops.
I took all my wet clothes and I hung them around my truck, and I headed straight to Kamloops. And that was just over 800 kilometers I had to drive that night. So I literally drove straight there. I only stopped for some gas, and when I arrived, it was midnight. As I was sleeping in the early hours of the morning, I heard boom, and something hit my car. And I woke up right away, looked around, and there's a guy walking around my truck, and he was hitting the windows.
It was unnerving for him. Andy called the police just to make sure he'd be safe and ready to compete in a few hours' time.
So I had about five and a half hours sleep at most. And, you know, I woke up just shaking in fear and adrenaline. So yeah, so I went to the competition site, and I started my warm-up, and I was actually feeling surprisingly pretty good. And I thought, you know what, if you just stay focused and keep on this track, like, you're gonna do this. And when it came time to it for my very first throw, I threw the standard 71.14 meters, and just 14 centimeters over the qualifying mark of 71 meters.
In Guangzhou, Andy once again found the common feature of all his adventures, bad weather. He was cursed by rain right up until the warm-up of the competition. Not the best preparation for the javelin event. The 25-year-old Canadian was about to face his first international competition as well.
When I got in, it was really neat. I mean, we got to walk into the call center, we sat down. You could see the stadium through the other end of the building, and when we got to walk into the stadium finally, and it opened up to see the crowd, it's like, wow, it's a beautiful, huge stadium, and people are cheering there. So pretty surreal feeling.
After all that, Andy didn't make the podium. But was it so important? He'd taken part in the Universiad, he'd worn the Canadian jersey, he'd kept his promise to his mother. More than a sports event, the Guangzhou Universiad was for him something of a journey of initiation.
It's very clear for me that the lesson is you can go through many different defeats, many different setbacks, and as long as you stay committed to that, you can accomplish what you've set out to accomplish.
Andy White of Canada at the World University Games, Guangzhou 2015. Still to come on Campus Sport, basketball 3-on-3. And the remarkable world of the champion fencer, Britta Heidemann.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.